British Railways era of non-steam traction. As with volumes 1 and 2, we'll be looking at some of the rarer locomotives seen at this time, as well as the more mundane run-of-the-mill engines. We hope to provide something for everyone. We begin where we left off at the end of volume 2, with class 52 diesel hydraulic number D1006. Snow Hill. The engine had come back to Birmingham with the return working of the daily Pullman service. It was the early 1960s. Sand livery. Still at Wolverhampton, Western Talisman is seen reversing the stock of this passenger train. another EMU still at Long Buckley. Rare on this line, but towards the end of their careers, they turned up on several of these coal trains. further side, this is the signal box at Banbury North Junction. At one time it controlled trains running to and from the Great Central, but by this time it was just a block post. It too was removed soon after the shots were taken. Also at Rullin, we see 55022, the Royal Scots Parade. The Black Watch was a feeder bomb. That was class 31, number 31314. Station to its great western adversary, Snow Hill. This brought many unusual visitors, like these class 40s. Class 81 electric was seen at Nuneaton. Even further back in time, to the late 1950s, some early workings of the class 31s in North London. Used to work trains on the Metropolitan line from Liverpool Street Station to the Aylesbury line, where they were replaced by steam locomotives. When these shots were taken in the late 1950s, their replacement by standard LT electric trains was imminent. this time the Class 56 would have been virtually brand new. Class 20, 20075 and 20076, also at Trent. Another Class 20, this one was number 20178. This is New Tile in 1962. The Class 26 was later to become number 26039. This Class 20 is seen at Brechin. And again on the Inverbervie branch. Was an Arica. The rail bus was filmed near Stirling. This Class 06, a 1958 Barclay 040 design, had a brake horsepower of 204. It's seen at Inverness. Engines on Fort William shed. And this Class 27 was at Ballachulish. Behind a Class 20 at Lossiemouth. Western Pathfinder again, this time in blue. And D1010, Western Campaigner, leaving Cambridge. At this time in the mid-1970s, the Class 52s were used on many of the West Country expresses. Initial problems with the cars had been ironed out, and by now they were giving good reliability. Sadly, it proved to be an Indian summer for the class, and standardization meant that all would be gone by February 1977. Here we see D1022, Western Sentinel, at Mitcham. Sister locomotive D1021, Western Cavalier, at Hale. Milk trains are once again planned to run on British Railways. This one behind D1067, Western Druid, was filmed in the summer of 1975, when milk was still transported daily by rail. More Westerns. Firstly, Western Advocate at Peel. Also at Peel, Western Trooper. Reading, one of the last members of the cast to receive the corporate blue livery, D1056 Western Sultan. The ill-fated 1055 Western Advocate, which crashed near Worcester. Plymouth. Emperor, also at Plymouth. Reading. This is D1040, Western Queen. The High Met was also seen at Reading. And this is another blue Pullman, still at Reading. One of the green warships. 1973, all the remaining blue Pullmans were painted in this predominantly grey livery. This one is seen arriving at Paddington. Class 52 also arrived at Paddington. It was April 1973. The blue Pullmans ended their days on Paddington Bristol train. Here are some shots taken in Berkshire during their final weeks in service. Electric locomotives passing Harrow and Wilston station, scene of the horrific accident in October 1952. Another green DMU, this one at Birmingham New Street. Was a Fell diesel mechanical locomotive built in 1951. It had a relatively short working life, mainly on the Midland Main Line, and by the late 1950s could be seen dumped out of service at Derby. Also at Derby we see some of the Metrovic Kobos. Like the Class 29s, these locomotives were highly unsuccessful and had a short working life. They were powered by a two-stroke costly diesel engine. Also in the picture we see some Bobo Class 24s. Stetchford during the diversions due to mainline electrification. By this time, many of the West Coast expresses were class 40 haul. The class 40s were introduced in 1958. They had a tractive effort of £52,000 and a total brake horsepower of 2,000. One 16-cylinder English electric engine powered six traction motors. Station. Heimic diesel hydraulic number D7028 was seen at Maidenhead. Although a very successful design, this class of locomotives were considered surplus to requirements and were all sold to Holland. And this one of the smaller Bobo DC electrics at Dinting. Also on the Manchester Sheffield DC electric line could be seen these three-car electric multiple unit sets. They work between Manchester and Hatfield and Glossop. Bedford, this is class 45P. A pair of class 25. Another peak. And one which carried the name Third Carabineer. It was numbered D99. Class 31 was at Burbage Common on the Nuneaton to Leicester line.
They showed all three liveries worn by the D-800s.
blue, red and green. And another green warship, this time at Snow Hill Station. Western Enterprise again, also at Snow Hill. Birmingham New Street station, you see this Stania Black 5 steam locomotive hauling a failed DMU. Two more, taken at Rugeley. Thank you. and an 08 shunter being passed by a bubble car. The Class 23, or Baby Deltic, was at Derby in 1974. Also at Derby was the fairing of the Class 25 and Class 45 PC. Same location, we see one of the original Class 44 peaks, number 44003 Skiddaw. This pair of Class 20s were at Camworth High Level. And the Class 45 was just south of the station. We end Volume 3 back at Bletchley in 1988 at D200. Still in undercoat, makes its way north on this special working to the National Railway Museum at York.